blood? The dog's blood? Or Daniel's blood? Oh no!
Daniel?
That's a mountain lion? Oh my god.
Oh shit. Daniel!
Is that the dog?
Move.
It killed her! She was my friend!
Calm down, okay? Listen.
Leave me alone! No!
It's food. Wow. This icon of blues. Step forward.
Go away! Go!
That's food. It's not gonna back down.
No! No! Mushroom! Why?
I had a bad feeling about letting the dog out and running, walking away.
Daniel. I'm so sorry. It just wouldn't have changed anything to kill it.
I wanted to walk back out the sliding doors, but I couldn't. To stand out with them.
I'm right here. It's all right.
Well, one dog down. One less mouth to feed. It's so cruel to say, I know. That was literally the last place I looked, unfortunately. This time I had no idea, guys.
Here. You should do it.
Stinks too. Right before we had to leave, like... Could have just left and the dog would be alive.
That's it. It's bullshit.
You wanna say something?
We can't even bury her.
Well, unless you wanna say something.
Goodbye, Mushroom. You were such a good puppy. I'll always remember. Running through the snow with you. And how you snuggled. And I'll never forget you. Never.
Rest in peace.
Good girl. Rest in peace. You won't be forgotten.
Sean, you think she's up in heaven?
Yep.
With Dad?
All dogs go to heaven. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sure he will look after her.
Wait.
How could you say nah?
What about his allergies?
Don't worry, Inanna.
Yeah, I'll take that with you.
There's no allergies up there. They'll be fine together. Okay. We should go. It's getting late.
Okay.
Allergies are a problem with the physical body. Yeah, I'll bring that with you. Oh, I thought someone was coming around sniffing up their shadow. Like, what the hell is that on the right side? Well, if these people ever come back here, they're gonna be like, what the hell? People have all wolves inside.
Wish we didn't have to go.
Broke the window, boarded it up.
I like having a house again.
Come on. Let's hit the road.
I wonder if Stan is.
What about my traps? Should we leave them up?
Yeah.
They'll protect the next runaways to stay here.
I put both you in charge of the house, Mushroom.
So long, my dudes.
Yeah, I don't think that house had any insulation. No electricity, no running water. I mean, other than the running water of the river, which is awesome in itself. What if you could set something up that would run a really long hose from the river and use that as like a running water? You just have to get some like suction created, right? And the water could flow right through. It'd be problematic. With a long hose like that, any kind of kink would stop the water from flowing adequately. Maybe I'm overthinking this. Or is he just walking like a zombie? Just use your force power to levitate. Bet you couldn't strap tennis rackets to your feet. Yeesh. If you had the right gear, you could have caught fish and cooked that up. I guess this is the part where the licensed music would play. Because I've chosen the menu option to remove that. Bye, dear. Thought I had something stuck in my monitor for a second. Now it's nighttime. Where's the tent? Wait, where's the tent they got? He stole that tent. Kidding me? They left it behind? That's where he had his lair, so why didn't they use the tent there? Daniel's lair. That's a highway? Huh. Can only walk like that for so long. Beaver Creek welcomes you. Insert more licensed music. So we never got a cell phone, right? Couldn't call them. They have no idea we're coming, right?
We made it, Daniel.
Reynolds!
It's been a long time since I was here.
When was that?
Before you were born.
Okay, Reynolds is from the Prelude. She visits, she knocks on the door, Mrs. Reynolds, and trying to figure out if Chris, I think is his name, is the kid there, if he's alright. She knows that the husband has a drinking problem and all this stuff. Yeah, you gotta watch that episode. So we've seen Reynolds. You can call her on the phone. And yeah, so that Reynolds is their grandparents. I didn't realize there's one of these, like, Christmas tree type things in the yard next door from Chris. So the Reynolds must be the next door neighbors. Didn't get that for sure while I was playing the prelude like that. And there were kids watching from the backyard as Chris fell from the treehouse. And it looked like Chris used the power to stop himself. But I think it was Daniel who did that. So, and that was during the day, though, so we'll see that happen maybe tomorrow?
Come here. Let me check you out.
So we'll see Mrs.
Claire
Reynolds
likes
again.
Everything super clean.
Claire.
Dad said she got pissed because he let me bring a snowball in the house. You don't want to look like total pigs.
Just, you know, somewhat pigs. Now, I'm sure they know what happened, but they're not expecting.
What if they went on vacation? Or something?
We'll figure out something.
And I guess they won't be answering now, will they?
I'm sorry, we don't want any of...
Sure you do.
Hello, Claire.
Sean? Oh my.
That's his grandma, right?
Is
just
that...
just calls her Claire,
Daniel?
Not grandma.
What's going on out here? I heard...
Look who's here! After all this time.
Wait, it's not the grandma.
What the hell are you doing here?
Steven, watch your mouth.
Well... it's kind of a long story.
They said they had no family here.
Oh, you poor thing. You know he's sick, right?
Yeah, but...
Okay. Inside. Both of you.
No kidding. I really want to stay outside and hang out. Didn't they say they had no family? Is their grandparents? I forget. It was. They had no family in the U.S., but maybe Mexico. Oh, I'll probably find out. Oh, no, that's right. It's their mother's family, the mother's side of the family. We don't know what their mother did. Something that their mother did. That they owe them.
Hey, is it warm enough for you?
Oh, yeah.
These two...
Feels nice and...
Owe the kids.
Toasty.
I gave Daniel some cough medicine, but you should have taken better care of him.
Yeah, that's a little hard out on the road, lady. What do you think we're here for? I really don't like her. So, yeah, that these two... Oh, Sean and Daniel, because of what Sean and Daniel's mother did. Whatever that is.
He could have been worse. You were lucky. Steven, may I talk to you for a second?
You should be glad he's not worse. And he's lucky, too. Don't like them.
So, how's the kid?
Oh, shit. I'm so hungry, my belly hurts.
Oh, Steven, what are we going to do?
I don't know.
Maybe we should call Gus.
Gus?
I'm not sure that's a good idea. Do we really want to involve other people?
Well, maybe he can help. We have to do something.
Who's Gus?
Police officer was killed, Claire, you know. Our grandchildren are wanted by the police for murder.
I know. What if Sean is guilty?
Mm-mm.
Sleeping in our home, next to us.
That's just ask him what happened.
I'm not the one with the powers.
Figure something out.
I don't want to look at things because I'm listening to them.
All right, Stephen. Oh, Lord.
Yeah, I didn't look at anything. Because he just talked over them.
Are you all right, honey?
Well,
you want
nice?
More tea?
Thanks. I'm good.
Well, Sean, do you want to talk about...
The police called us a few weeks ago. They're looking for you as suspects in a homicide and for assault and robbery in a gas station?
Wasn't me.
Now, if you want us to help you, did you hurt that police officer in Seattle?
No. Seriously?
Seriously? You really think I killed that cop?
No, don't get mad. Sean, we have to ask. We only know what we saw in the news.
All I know is that he shot dead. And now he's gone.
Oh, sweetie. We are so sorry for what happened to your father, but why did you run away if you're innocent?
Because they thought we're immigrants or something. To protect Daniel.
I didn't want Daniel to see Dad. Like that. I felt like I had to protect him.
I understand, but...
You know the police would separate us. Maybe forever. Daniel would end up in foster care.
You can't be sure, Sean. Anyway, at least you've managed to come here alive. We're glad you two are okay.
I hate to think what could have happened to both of you. You need to think of long-term solutions now.
I tried. I swear. But I can't do everything.
So, what are your plans?
Do I trust her? I don't know if I trust her to tell her this. Or him necessarily, but especially her. Figure it out.
I'm trying to figure it out. I just want to watch out for Daniel. Wait for him to get better. Before we take the road again.
How can you look out for your brother if you're both running from the police?
Because we're together?
You two are gonna stay with us.
Oh, Stephen. Maybe we should...
After your mother left, your dad never really wanted us in your life. I can't blame him. But you're still part of our family.
What did she do?
We want to prove it, okay?
Just abandon them, I guess. You're not scared?
Whoa, really? Aren't you scared? The police already called you.
Lordy, yes. But we were also scared for you.
That's why you'll have to be careful around here. Beaver Creek is small and nosy.
We can stay? Serious? Awesome! Ooh, Sean, guess what? There's a huge model train upstairs.
Hey, you're supposed to be resting, young man.
Nice shirt. Yeah.
Yes, he is. But he seems better already. Anyway, you and Daniel will stay here. At least until Daniel's better. We'll see what happens next. So, I bet you're hungry.
Yeah,
let me fix you something.
Can't stay indefinitely. I mean, they wouldn't be able to go to school, get jobs, anything. Without being found out. I want to look around downstairs.
How do you feel, Super Wolf?
Way better. It's nice and warm in here. And the food? Yum.
Yeah. Feels good.
Feeling better? You look cozy.
Yeah. I love that bed. Thanks, Grandma.
Lighter.
Good.
There.
Your temperature is down.
I'm way better now.
You still need to take it easy.
Just grabs his
How about
his
if we say a little prayer and give thanks?
It's like a bedtime story, right?
Well, this is a bit like this, yes. Except the story comes from up there.
The ceiling.
So are we ready to pray? Just follow my lead.
He has no idea. I mean, obviously they didn't do it in their house, but it's funny, he has no idea what it is and just in general. Sure.
Sure. We need all the help we can get.
Can you ask the blessed dad? And Sean. And Mushroom. And you and Grandpa. And,
Yourself?
Everybody else.
Oh my, you are so sweet.
Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya.
Thank you, Lord. For bringing Sean and Daniel safe and sound into our house. Take care of Esteban and,
Mushroom.
Please, give us the strength to get over the hardships of the past and the trials yet to come. Amen.
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 Okay.
Is that part of it?
It's bedtime. Try to get some rest. You still need it. And no roughhousing in here.
No worries.
Roughhousing?
We're too tired. Good night. Oh, and thanks again.
Good night, Grandma.
Okay. Daniel, you can't let them see your power. Don't forget that. You know what's gonna happen, though.
Feels so nice to have a bed again. And a bathroom.
Grandma's hear that. Plus,
Grandma's gonna do something that upsets Daniel, and the power's gonna come out.
You don't smell anymore.
Whatever. Well, Claire seems pretty caring. And nice. I guess Steven is too. I hope we'll be fine here.
I think so. And the more important thing is you'll have time to get better.
Sean? Are we in Mom's old room?
Nah, I don't think this is the one. Not from what I remember. But it's been a while.
Could we check it out tomorrow? Maybe find some of her stuff?
Why?
Why would you want to do that?
I just don't know anything about her.
Daniel, I understand. But we need to focus on where we are now and where we're off to. Mom left us. She made her choice.
That's just how it happened.
We gotta make ours. And we can't keep going back. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I guess.
Hey, man. You've been doing so great with your... well...
power.
You know. I was wondering... how do you do it?
I don't know. I concentrate and... it just happens.
Does it hurt?
Wait. Does it hurt?
Nah. It's kinda itchy, though.
Itchy?
And exhausting.
Sorry. Anyway, remember the rules, right? We really don't want Claire or Stephen to start asking questions.
I know.
Yep.
Don't show, don't talk.
Just keep that in mind and everything should be fine. Sleep tight, little cub.
Now, we don't know why the mother left. Maybe the mother has the power and Daniel got the power from the mother. And the mother left, maybe something having to do with her power. Maybe people, I can see people are after her. It'll be more known by, I don't know, maybe there was a secret agency after her or something like that. Beaver Creek, Oregon. 1 week later. Wow. So they really settled in by now, I'm sure. Maybe she left because she figured she had to keep them safe. She didn't have good control over her powers or something like that. Maybe she had a temper and her powers would flare out. It's all just guessing here. But she is the big mystery. We don't know anything about the mother.
Oh, man. I could sleep all day long in this bed. But I'm way too hungry.
Alright, let's look at stuff. There's the window.
This is pretty good so far.
Inherent.
I love that Steven only has crime and train books.
Inherent mice. Steven's book.
This is pretty good so far.
That's what I looked at.
I love that Steven only has crime and train books.
That's picture.
That's cool. Claire dug this up for us. That's such a baller in his suit. Man. I miss that dirty little dog.
A little dirty, huh?
So much more than I thought I would. I don't even know how Beaver Creek looks like. We're not allowed to get out.
Just a bunch of houses. I don't think you're missing much. Sketchbook we can't look at yet. Clothes.
Claire wanted to throw her clothes away, but we convinced her that with some sewing and cleaning, it would be enough.
I'm not gonna get dressed yet. Dice?
That's a cool memento of our secret cabin in the woods.
The hell? The pirate game?
Daniel looks like a total thug in his new pajamas. Can't believe we actually spent a month out there by ourselves and survived.
Night in the Forest. Found it in one of the bedrooms. I finally have time to read it now. Canteen. Probably the best thing we found in the old house. The tent. Yeah, they didn't use it, so they do still have it. Old tarp. This tarp will keep us dry if it starts raining or snowing while we're on the road. Croco disc. Space scuba. Canteen. Demon blonde. Too creepy. Journal. I got more. Oh, a whole bunch more. Right. Like, how can this kid win every time at dice game? Cheating? Yeah, I read that. December 1st. Huge progress today. Stopped a snowball in motion, plus heavy rock. Daniel getting worse. No fever yet, but no food left. Leaving tomorrow for Beaver Creek. There's a sketch. Sorry, pup. December 2nd. December 3rd. Burning cold. Had to carry Daniel for over 2 miles. No one stopping to help us. What's wrong with these guys? Really? December 5th. Dan getting better. He's eating like a horse. Guess that's good. Been hanging out with CNS a lot. Pretty awkward after all these years. Claire and Steven, right? They're walking on eggshells Not to talk about Seattle or Karen. There's a huge elephant following us everywhere. Rude. The elephant's not rude. Claire Reynolds, Stephen Reynolds. December 6th. December 7th. Reynolds rules. Discretion. Wait. Discretion equals don't leave the house. Disconnection equals no phone, no internet. Daily chores. Homework for Daniel, LMAO. Good luck with that, Claire. Bored AF. Grateful for being here, but need to get out. Gotta think of what's next. Ain't no chill for the wicked. Huh. No rest for the wicked. December 9th. Some more drawing.
Pretty badass.
You in the bathroom? Like, taking a bath? Earmuffs?
Thanks, Claire, but I will never wear these things.
Oops. Wooden blocks.
Daniel was training his precision with ease. Fucking awesome.
Nothing to say there, wait. Okay, Reynolds' house. I don't remember seeing that picture. Well, that's, I guess that's Steven. Space toy?
Yep. Daniel knows how to milk grandma for toys. Good. He deserves to be spoiled.
Okay, that's everything in the house. I'm interested in the cross. That's an evil laugh. Alright, he's gonna say he can't go out without his clothes on.
Get dressed before you go, dude. Claire thinks breakfast is like a job interview.
Yeah. So not my type of people.
Claire wanted to throw her clothes away.
Oh.
We convinced her that with some sewing and cleaning, it would be enough. Alright. I'm allowed to go out now.
I'm allowed to go out now.
Sean!
Oh, that's what you're doing out here.
Sean, are you awake?
Nope.
Breakfast's almost done, so come down when you're ready, okay?
Okay!
Not ready.
Choo-choo!
I'm glad they get along so good. Daniel's definitely the ideal grandson.
Yeah, but we're gonna scare the passengers away.
I don't care! Yeah. Faster!
What's up?
Ah, look who's here. But you're too late for the 9:15 express.
It's okay. I'll take the next one.
It will leave after breakfast.
Look, you're square dancing.
Don't be late this time.
I won't.
Won't be late this time, huh?
All aboard!
Looking around.
We stopped our training session since we got here, so sucks.
No, you train with the blocks. I just said.
Oh, man. How did we survive for weeks out there with no hot water? I used to hate brushing my teeth. Just like Daniel. Now I can't get enough toothpaste. Saw some teeth in there a few nights ago. Wonder if it's Claire's or Steven's.
Oh, brother.
Wow. They sure did stock us up on clothes for the winter.
It's all their clothes? How do you know it's all your clothes and not their clothes? And they put their teeth in here, why wouldn't they put their clothes in here? Grab bar.
Hope I'll never have to hold on to a bar to take a shit.
Oh, I was looking at the grab bar, not grabbing a bar.
They have so many pills and stuff to take.
Mm-hmm.
Sucks to be old. It's crazy how everything is neat and tidy here.
Crazy.
Quite the change from our last home.
Yeah. A cabin with no insulation. Is the other bathroom?
Better not sneak in.
I thought I said
they
bathroom.
Won't like it.
Does it say bedroom? Oh, it does say bedroom.
Watch out for any train hoppers.
Oh, that's, the option's gone.
It's been locked ever since we got here. And I kind of don't give a fuck.
Oh, jeez. Really?
Fuck. I broke this thing like 10 years ago.
Oh, wow.
I can't believe they fixed it. And kept it.
Mostly.
Choo-choo!
So careful, Chief. You're going too fast.
We have to. We're late on schedule.
Yeah, but we're gonna scare the passengers away.
That conversation sounds familiar.
I don't care. Faster.
Better hit the kitchen quick. Claire's waiting for us.
I want to look around first. Reminds me of like chutes and ladders or something. That's the kitchen, huh?
Man.
Okay, go outside.
Claire's food smells so good.
Yep.
I'm starving.
Completely avoiding it.
Whoa! We made it!
I hope we won't get Claire and Steven into trouble.
Probably after we have breakfast, we can look at stuff in here, I guess. Trying to see if we could see the treehouse from the Prelude story. That looks like it could be the shed. Maybe from that window.
Oh my, look who's awake.
We're not gonna make it there.
Good morning, sleepyhead.
It's that bed. Feels like a cloud.
I know. You can sit down, Sean.
Trying to see out
the window. Aren't you hungry?
Trying to see out the window. I mean, jeez. Oh. Yeah, the window's in here. This is the front of the house, so it would be over there.
And watch out for any train hoppers.
Wait, is that it? That's it. That's the tree house that Chris, or I think is that name, falls out of. And then it looks like he puts his hand out and stops himself from falling. But I bet you it's Daniel who actually does that. Because what are the odds that both of them would have that power?